From this to that.
Yo, what's up, people? Everybody's good. Everybody's Gucci. What a day off. I am the second wildest baby. What's going on? And you know what it is? Time for another flashback. Yo. Today we gonna kind of like dibble and dab a little bit into the essence of the way we communicate now and how we communicated just 20 years ago. The whole evolution of our communication has totally changed in infrastructure and design right up under our nose. And you don't even believe it. Watch this. Imagine going on a date with your honey, and a third party is forced to come along. Right then and there, psychologically, whether you know it or not, subconsciously, whether you know it or not, the whole meaning of your date with your honey changes right then and there on both of y'all behalf. The date that y'all was finna have, mark that out, please. Exit. It's not gonna happen. No matter how hard you try, destiny is not gonna allow it. Because that third party is an unknown variable. So that means the factors change. And it's the same thing with the cell phone. The cell phone fills in a void for us personally, and it's our little creature of capture of our personality. And it's a
From this to that.
It may seem harmless, but that little doohickey, my brother, my sister, is a big monster of distraction. Yes, sirree, Bob. I'm here to tell you. You act totally different with your cell phone, adding the internet access, of course, than if you did not have it. If our system wasn't designed to actually function with this piece of device, then we would not be acting the way that we do. The cell phone has a tendency to make you more secluded. And the way that a human being is designed, we communicate and interact as a unit. Not secluded. So as time passes, a transition takes place, and more times over, you find yourself wouldn't be alone. And you don't know why? Because the cell phone has drawn you to this world of me. Yeah, me. I'm not kidding. This is your business. The cell phone actually is a personal device. Advantage. It drives you and makes you want to communicate a different way now because you don't want that fear of being bothered. I don't want to be bothered. So you go into your little world with your cell phone and your husband and your wife sit right next to you and you're texting each other back and forth, and they're not even 50 feet away. And they're not even 20 feet away. Kids, they get involved, but they use it recklessly and wildly. They don't understand that now I'm going to be the king, queen, god of this world. That's what it does. So, when you implement this device and make it common, it changes the whole face of humanity in its entirety. That's why it's easy for them to jump on the population control. As homosexuality, artificial intelligence, chemical warfare, however they do, when God's whole plan was bond, the bondage. That's how we procreate. You can't make a baby with your husband sitting where you across that room every night. So when you take the desire to want to be up under each other and amongst each other with the cell phone, it starts taking other desires away as well. It's like unraveling a ball of yarn. It might take you a while, but when you get through and look around, you're going to see a mess all over the place. And the core of that ball is nowhere near the size of it when the yarn was wrapped around it. You guessed it. That's the mess you make. Your life. And it's just like anything else. And us human beings, we are a very controlling creature of habit. It's like everything else, drugs, alcohol, sex. You want to dominate. And the cell phone allows you to do that. So you fall in love with your cell phone. Because of the internet, totally. If the internet was not on your cell phone, it would just be a normal device of communication. You get it? Back in the day, you call your honey, you go pick up, y'all go to date. Smooch it, kick it, make it now. Let me kiss that mouth. Yeah, you might get to something. But now, all in the mood, all in the dinner there, all everywhere. Y'all just typing away and Googling and looking up shit. Hey, honey, let's go buy this. It's in California. Don, we're in Miami. Right. I know. We're leaving to go there next year. It just makes your mind so occupied and confused with illusion. Because our mind is meant to sponge and soak. And when you put an unlimited knowledge device in your palm of your hand, then guess what happens? You always gotta find something else to do. Even if you just go on Facebook every 3 minutes. Did somebody hit the like button? Did somebody hit my messenger? Did somebody? And that's what it does. It gives you that drive of anticipation. And now you don't have time to bond with your wife and be that strong, provided man. And honey, you don't have time to be a nurturer. You got other things to do, like clip your tulips. Where are the kids? Hell, we don't know. They're around here somewhere. They're only 2 and 3 years old. Right? So next time you pick your cell phone up, how about you make a date with your honey? And say, you know what, every night for a week, we're turning our phones off at 9 p.m. and leaving them off till 7 a.m. Try it. And if you can go a week, I guarantee you, there will be a change. Been a flashback, baby. From this to that. You know what Wallace doing. Second Wallace on spitting back. See y'all later, baby. So I'm going to get your hard hat. So what I do? Whoop gang, right? I'll be back.
From this to that.